Going to church is very important for believers as it provides a sense of community and a sense of belonging in the body of Christ, but also giving believers the opportunity to hear a message from their pastor that God has been speaking to him about. And it's very common, I've seen it every Sunday that I've gone in, the believers will go into church, they'll sit down, we'll have praise and worship for a little bit, and then the pastor will move on into his message. But after a week passes after your Sunday service, you're probably wondering, wait, what did the pastor talk about? What can I take away from this message, and how did I apply it to my life this week? And the problem is, you may not remember everything that the pastor said. And then you get to the next Sunday and you hear another message, and then you get through another week and you realize, oh wait, I don't remember anything from that last message, or I don't remember much from that last message. But that's the problem that I found myself in when I was at a young age. I was trying to remember what the pastor told me at the most recent Sunday service that I attended, but I couldn't remember it at all. And then my mind was brought to this verse, which can be found in Joshua 1:9 and also in verse 8 as well. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous, do not be frightened, and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. So looking back in verse 8, we can see that we're supposed to know this book. Honestly, these are the two most important verses for a believer when they're going into church on Sunday, because they're able to see that they're supposed to take something away from the service, not just to go and experience something from service. And today I want to provide you with the answer to being able to remember things that you heard on Sunday with note-taking. But taking notes should be a very vital part of the believer's time when they're going to church on Sunday, because they're sitting there to learn from their pastor what they've heard from God. And I think it's important for us to be able to look back on that word, to be able to hear from God, and to say, okay, what are you trying to speak to me about this week so I can grow in my faith and in my relationship with you? And I know that taking notes can seem kind of confusing because there are so many different ways you can take notes, but I want to provide with you today a way and a template to be able to take notes when you go into church on Sunday. And how you choose to take notes is totally up to you. With all the technology that we have today, there is a myriad of ways that you can do it. On the YouVersion app, which I talk about a lot on this channel, there's a way that you can click on notes under each individual verse that you tap on. And if you'd like for me to do a video on that, leave a comment in the comment section down below. But there's also different ways that you can do it. You could use any kind of like Microsoft Word app that's on your computer. You can use apps that are on your phone or tablet. But personally, I like to use notebooks. Notebooks give me a way to be able to write things down, look back through them, underline things, and add them in such a way that is relevant to me and is easier for me to read. But it's totally up to you, and I encourage you to find a way that's easiest for you. You don't have to do it the way I do it, for sure. Try and find the way that's easiest for you to be able to take notes and also pay attention to the pastor. This is what I am going to be showing you today. And it's a simple template. It's not very difficult. It just provides you with a basic outline for how your notes can look, and it keeps them organized. So at the top you can see that there's the speaker that you can write, and then you have the date. And in the center you can write the sermon note or the sermon title, because a lot of pastors like to do sermon series. And so when you're looking at a series of sermons, you want to be able to go look back on what the pastor previously talked about. And so that's a good way for you to be able to keep track of what the pastor said or talked about in the past. And then the next part, you can see there's an intro or an introduction, because most pastors often open up with either a story or some kind of introduction leading into their main sermon. And when you look at that introduction, you're better able to figure out where the pastor was going throughout the rest of the message when you look back in your notes. And then you have the body of the sermon, which is broken up into three main points often. There can be more, there can be less. But the way that you can number these and keep track of what points that the pastor's talking about better helps you associate the flow of the message and what he's trying to convey to you personally. One thing I personally like to do is write the verse that they mention out to the side of their main point, and sometimes I'll even write the translation that they're using when they're speaking from that specific verse. So sometimes a pastor may say in their first point that they're talking from a verse in the ESV, which is the English Standard Version, but in the second point, they may be looking at a translation of a verse that's found in the New King James Version, or as I usually put out to the side, NKJV. And when I go back and personally study the notes for myself, I'm better able to figure out where he was trying to go with his message and what he was trying to convey to me. And then under each main point, you can have something called subpoints, because most often pastors go through different passages of scripture or focus on a group of scriptures that they want to talk about under their main points. And so I encourage you to go look into that and being able to see that they have subpoints with different topics. They may go off on a tangent for a little bit, but then return back to their main body of their sermon. And that's okay. By doing this kind of a format, by being able to follow this kind of a template, it's easy for you to be able to take notes and to be able to convey them to yourself later on, and possibly even if you're working with a Bible study group or a discipleship group. And then at the end, you can have a conclusion, or you wrap up any final notes that the pastor may have, or things that you personally hear in the message that you feel like you should take away from the message. Because ultimately, your pastor can't be accountable for your faith. You have to be accountable for your faith. We know that on the last day, at the judgment seat of Christ, we know that we're all going to be held accountable for what we've done in our lives. And one thing that we should be held accountable for to ourselves is our personal growth in faith. And I believe that taking notes in church provides you the opportunity to help you grow in your faith when you're taking time out of your week to be able to personally study God's Word. And so I want to thank you for this video. If you have any more recommendations for videos that you'd like for me to do, just leave a comment in the comment sections down below and I'll help you there. Also, make sure that you like and subscribe this video if you like this video and want to see more. Also, make sure that you follow me on Instagram at Working From The Well and also at John J.R. Tallman. And you can also find me on Facebook at Working From The Well.